So do you think that there's been more violent crime?
At the last 2 years, maybe.
Do you think that has anything to do with refugees?
Yeah.
We got a cab about to pick us up. We're on our way to meet with Nils Karlsson, who's a deputy mayor. We're told he's very liberal. Some people say he's centrist. But we're going to Rosengard Central. It's, you know, Rosengard is one of the problem areas, we're told. But Central isn't that bad. It's not the worst part of the area. There's going to be some journalists who are going to follow us around. But this is our, you know, official government minder tour. Now, I'm being a bit facetious. But we're going to get, like, an official view from somebody who works in government about one of the problem areas and what's currently going on. Donald Trump made Sweden a very important place because I certainly don't think this was the country to call out if he wanted to make an example of some kind of, like, you know, migrant issue, because, you know, you have the terror attacks in France, you know.
Yes, I would have put the focus on France, perhaps Paris, yeah. The suburbs of Paris.
Right.
But I see the right wing sites often use Malmo and Sweden as examples. It's really interesting that he puts the focus on Sweden because his would-be competitor in the presidential race, Bernie Sanders, talked a lot about Sweden and the social programs and the taxes. And, but you know, in a more positive voice.
I will say, people have asked that we go to Ramels Vag. Should we walk near there? Or?
I'm really not. This is not my home area. Yeah, yeah. I used to live a couple of blocks down there, but Malmö is really small. I'm all yours. Let's go where I thought we should go to Törnrosen, the oldest part of Rosengård, where there is the most child poverty and so. But we can go to Ramels Vag, is where the cars are burning, so we can go there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We should go there simply because this is, people expect us to die.
Okay, let's go there and hopefully not die. Well, the real violent crimes have increased in Malmö, while the other crimes have been at a more stable level or even decreased. So there is a problem in Malmö.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think it has anything to do with Sweden bringing in refugees?
No, I don't. But I do think it has something to do with the people who have come here as refugees sometimes. For the last 20 years, are often stuck in poverty and unemployment, and we've really, when you don't see any future, crime is a way to gain respect and to gain status. And if you are a young male, that is all over the world. That is what you want.
Yeah.
You can turn to crime or violence.
We've heard a bunch of interesting things. One thing we heard from someone is that Sweden has very, very great welfare benefits. You know, the government takes care of its poor people.
And try to.
Yeah, I mean, much better than the United States, I hear, right? That there is housing provided and, you know, money, like stipends. Is this true?
Yeah? Yes, it's true. So you get it's not very much money you get, but you get enough to live.
Yeah.
And you get your housing paid. And so on.
There
is a problem, though. We don't have enough. We don't have enough apartments for everybody. So there, especially in this area, there are too many people living in too small spaces. But I find it's much more useful to talk about the problems if you want to solve them. Because if we cover them up or try to look away, then they will still be around.
Yeah, that's interesting because that's what a lot of conservatives have said. In the U.S., that simply acting like the problem isn't there won't fix them.
Well, that is true. I'll give them that.
Yeah. Well, how do you consider yourself? Are you, you know, liberal? Are you center? Are you conservative?
The words are used a bit differently in Sweden than they are
in
America.
Oh, I know, of course.
Here, I am most certainly a liberal.
Yeah. Some people told us that you were a liberal in Sweden, and I said a liberal in Sweden is probably very, very liberal to an American.
I'm trying to follow American politics a bit. I think some of you would call me a socialist,
okay.
Because liberals in Sweden are not against this free housing and stipends and so on, which are free healthcare, which what I get is often called socialistic ideas in America. But here I am a liberal.
Well, so violent crime has gone up, like murders.
There have been a significant increase in the number of murders in Malmo over the last few years.
One thing we found interesting, last year I believe there were 13, is that the number? We've gotten different numbers from different people.
I think it was 11.
11? One said 14, someone said 13, but I'll say we can settle on 11,
yes,
right around there.
But 11 murders on a population of 300,000 is very much.
For Sweden?
For Sweden, yes, of course. I'm talking in a Swedish or even European perspective, but 11 is much. We usually get around one or two a year in Malmö.
What's causing this increase in murders?
It's very hard to say specifically, but one thing I'm told by the police is that there used to be two gangs controlling the criminal side of Malmö, and they have dissolved either by growing old or by the police have made arrests, which leaves a vacuum for new, younger persons to see if they can grab a piece of the black markets in Malmö, the narcotics trade and so on. And they are young and they are not experienced and they have easy access to weapons, and those times tend to be violent times. We had a similar time in the 1990s when two rival gangs tried to see who
should
rule.
People have said that there is a huge influx in sexual crimes in Sweden. We've been told that it's simply because Sweden has a wider law, more encompassing, and that people tend to report more. But I guess I'd like to get your thoughts on the whole issue and just talk about it a little bit.
Well, Sweden has changed its laws regarding sexual assault and rape and sexual misconduct in a way that it's more encompassing. So it's more actions are defined as rape or sexual assault now than before. And every report is followed up and you get support for the crime victims and often rather speedy trials. And that increases the will to report the crime. If you know that something will be done, then you're more likely to report. And we're actually working now to get an even broader definition of rape through the Riksdag, the national parliament. Taking a large number of refugees when you don't have housing for everybody and you don't have a functioning job market, where there is a job market for people with the skill levels that most refugees tend to have, there is a language barrier, of course, is a strain on any society. I do think it's a moral obligation, though. The problem is the wars that make people, turn people into refugees, not the refugees. So of course it's a problem, but the crimes we've seen, the violent crimes, we have nothing to support, no evidence in support of thinking that it's the refugees who are committing these crimes, the violent crimes, the murders or the shootings or whatever. But the people born outside of Sweden are overrepresented in crime statistics.
Ah, I see. So then who, you know, Sweden has seen much more, Malmo has seen much more murders this past year. And one thing we've noticed is that I think we heard in the past 4 weeks there's been a murder every week.
There's been, I think it's been three murders since New Year's.
Oh, wow.
So, it's a lot. But the police hasn't apprehended anybody, and nobody has been convicted. So it's a bit early to say who has committed these murders. People born in Sweden, the unemployment rate in Malmö for those people is around 5 or 6%. But the unemployment rate for people born outside of Sweden is up to 40% here in some areas.
In the area
in all of Malmö, around 20%. And it's a big difference. If you're growing up and you see your parents are unemployed, your others in your age group are unemployed, you don't have access to the fancy cars or whatever. Crime is a way out of being stuck in poverty.
All right, well, we shouldn't take up too much time. We should get out of here, and you've got a place to go. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for taking the time to talk to me.
Yeah. So that was Nils. He's a politician. The interesting thing is, when we first came to this spot, the people here told us they had just experienced some kind of crime and the police were on their way, but we're told it wasn't a priority. They asked us not to speak about it, but at least, you know, I'd like to bring it up to let you know that this is the area we're in and this is what we experienced. And I'll also say, look, you know, Nils, he said he's biased, and you know that that's a very liberal perspective, so take that into account. We've got more interviews to do, we've got more experts to meet, and this is a daily thing, so, you know, expect more, right? We're gonna head out now, meet up with a family, and hopefully we'll be staying in Rosengard tonight, one of the problem areas.
Oh, so this is Johann, who reached out, and he lives in Rosengard. We're gonna go stay at his place and have dinner and go for a walk. So we're here with Johann at his flat in Rosengard. This is beautiful. This looks amazing.
Yeah,
it's very nice. I'm from the south side of Chicago. I've also been to places in Ukraine and Venezuela. And if this really is considered to be, you know, the poorest or worst place in Sweden, wow. I mean, Sweden's doing pretty well, right?
Yeah, I guess so. I mean,
the floors are very nice, and there's a lot of space, big rooms.
Yeah, yeah.
This is it's crazy to think that people view this as a war zone, like it's very bad, right?
Yeah. Right now it's dark, so you don't even see the war zone. But
but you assure me that
there are artillery all the time.
Gang battles happening.
Yeah.
Do you notice anything outside at night? Is any violence?
I mean, the one murder of the 16-year-old boy that was down at the Amelosgatan, the street down there. So I mean, we had the sirens on our wall.
Oh, wow.
So it was close, and that was, of course, frightening, but that's about it, I think.
Have there been any other incidents like that, or any kind of, maybe not a murder, but have you seen robberies or gang activity?
No, not at all. I mean, there was one 14-year-old that had like a pretty loud cracker, you know?
A firecracker?
Firecracker, yeah. Yeah, it's embarrassing, somehow. The people are even talking about it like that without knowing. I don't know.
Hi.
Hi there.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Are there people saying that coming, you know, not even specifying the area we go to? Like, if you just go in Rosengard, it's so bad. You know.
Mama.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it isn't bad. It has been...
Det
har varit mycket bättre innan. Mycket bättre.
Bättre.
Det har varit bättre på Rosengard.
Det var bättre innan? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, she thinks it was better before.
Before.
How long did you live here, Almedina?
24 years.
All right.
So do you think that there's been more violent crime?
At the last 2 years, maybe.
Do you think that has anything to do with refugees?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Does it scare you? Does that bother you?
No, not that much, because I think that... Jag fastnar. Jag tror det är mycket, alltså det här med kriminaliteten, där de själva liksom, det här mycket med hedersmord och mycket sånt här som försiggör. Alltså att vi som bor här behöver inte vara så rädda för detta här.
Nej. Yeah, she's kind of saying like the crimes are not concerning us really. It's like honor crimes maybe, things that goes on in the world that we don't know about. And it's so few, I mean, it's so narrow that we don't really feel like it affects us in our daily life.
There's a lot of people who think that, you know, you'll get robbed here, that there's a lot of sex crimes or anything like that.
No.
You know, that's not the case?
No, 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 no. Absolutely not. No. Absolutely not.
But it's interesting. You say that you feel that, you know, there is more crime.
There is more crime.
Yeah.
Absolutely. But I think it's between them.
Yeah.
But 10 years ago, I mean, when all the rise by 2008, things like that, you didn't. How were you affected by that? You feel like it's worse now than back then.
It is worse.
Okay.
It is worse.
Okay.
Do you think that taking in the refugees is a good thing? Is good for Sweden to, you know.
It's good to help people, of course, but if you come here and do those things, send them home.
Oh yeah.
Send them home. I am a refugee. I came to Sweden in 1992 when there was war in Bosnia. But I don't do shit. I work.
Yeah.
So kommit in I samhället.
Yeah, she's in the society. Yeah.
Do you think that the Swedish government is doing a good job, or is it doing it right? Yes.
I think they are doing a good job, of course. But now I'm going to speak Swedish again because I think it's hard. Jag tycker bara att de borde ha lite hårdare straff I Sverige.
Okay. Yeah. More harsher punishments.
Is that the government is making harsher punishments?
Amadina wants that.
You want more punishments? Okay. Oh, interesting.
I think so.
Yeah.
Jag tror att många hade
passat sig.
Ja, det tror jag.
That they would be more careful.
It's interesting that you say that you see crime and stuff like that. That's something we haven't heard from people in Malmo. They kind of wave it off like it's no big deal.
Yeah. Det beror på lite hur man kollar på det.
Depends on how you see it, Jesus.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Interesting. Well, thank you. So I guess, you know, what I'm starting to notice is that it's kind of like a relativity issue. You know, Sweden has experienced more murders than they have, or I should say Malmo has experienced a lot more murders in the past year. In the past 2 months, there were, I think, 4 murders. Some people said 3. But I guess when you don't have this crime, there's a lot of people who are not used to it, who are really scared by the news, mm-hmm. you know, hearing about an escalation in grenade attacks or gang activity. Mm-hmm. And then they build this perception that everything is getting really, really bad mm-hmm. when it's only a little bad.
Yeah. It's like having a healthy body, and then your toe is starting to hurt, and you run to the hospital. It feels like that, something like that.
Do you think that it's possible the crime, you know, they've said that in the past year that, you know, there have been more murders, right? Is it possible that crime could get worse? Do you think it's going to get better? I mean, you live here.
I don't know. I mean, if I would be afraid of that, I probably wouldn't live here. Somehow, it's hard to, with few words, describe a daily life, but, you know, I go here back and forth to work and to school, so I get so much more impressions of a place like this than these occasional yeah. things that are probably revolving around people that are from far out of my like sphere. I don't know. I mean, it happens in our same streets, in our same world, of course, and pretty close, which is scary, but they wouldn't do that to me. I there is nothing like...
You think it's like gang-on-gang stuff, like criminal
violence? Yeah, The last thing here I heard was some kind of jealousy thing, which is, of course, crazy. I don't know. It's lunacy, but I no one would do that to a random person. That wouldn't happen. Yeah.
Well, let's eat. So let's save the harder politics. I'll say this. We did the interview with Nils today, and, you know, he's obviously very liberal, but we want to come and experience, you know, Rosengard, so, you know, very grateful for Johann coming and inviting us into his home, which is very beautiful, by the way. We will have more videos up, so make sure to follow me on Twitter @TimCast. Subscribe to the YouTube channel if you like videos like this. We're doing a daily series, right? So we have to do it one step at a time as much as possible, and it is a lot of work. So I appreciate you, you know, sticking with it and staying tuned for more and more interviews. With that, I will say thank you all so much for watching. Comment below. I will read your comments. I'll see you tomorrow.